Well, it's finally here. Opening day. It's 5 a.m. We got about an hour and a half, under an hour and a half to daylight, but I got about a mile walk to knock out real quick. It's an easy walk, though, down a two-track across the river in a kayak, so. Here we go. This is plan B. Don't even know if there's turkey here or not. There was a couple weeks ago. Just gonna watch the woods wake up and enjoy the morning. It's cold as shit out here. We'll see y'all out there. Alright. Redbird just started singing. He just gobbled. About 250 from us. So we're gonna creep that way. See if we can make a play on him. Let's get it. Thank you. He gone. He gone. Boy. Oh, boy. Go get him before he tears himself up.
Sucker was ready to play this morning. Man. Heavy turkey. Golly.
Game perfect. It don't happen like that often. Gotta call the boys. Look at that right there. He's seen a season or two. Sure didn't act like it though. Fine turkey. Probably not, but about a 7.5-8-inch beard. Big heavy turkey. Sucker's got frost on his back. It's so cold this morning. It's like 28, 29. Just beautiful morning. We've had temps high, like 70s, 80s, last 3 weeks. And then we got, you know, it seems to always happen, a good cool snap right here at opening weekend. Opening week, really, is Wednesday. They were fired up yesterday morning at another spot, but that was my plan A spot. It was the other place. And I went in there and listened yesterday, and the turkeys were not where they had been being the last, like, week before. They were way down on private. It's like I really don't want to get in here and be way out of the game if they're in the same spot tomorrow morning. So I knew about this turkey. I came in here about a week and a half ago, and he was in generally the same spot within 100 yards, roosted on this big slough back here, and came in about 200 yards that way this morning, way before daylight. Just let everything calm down, had a deer blow at me, of course, which happens pretty much every time you step off in the river bottom. But I heard the first red bird, and probably 2 minutes later, he hammered. I mean, it wasn't even a little, like, clearing his throat gobbles. It was not pretty. I said, dang, that sounded kind of jakey. And then he hit again about a minute later, and I saw, oh, that's daddy. So I crept down here to about, I was about probably 60 from him on the roost. And I passed up the tree that I sat on because I was going to go to a bigger one right here behind me. And as soon as I came around that tree, he gobbled, and I looked up, and I could see him in the tree, and I said, oh crap. So I just froze for a second and started to fade back got a tree in between me and him, and I curled around this tree, I sat on, and it was perfect because between me and him, there was one, this big oak tree behind me that was I wanted to set up on. And he kept gobbling, so I knew I was in the clear, and set up, took a deep breath, kind of got my thoughts together. Did not split my reeds this morning. This is the same mouth call that I've been playing with for a month now in the truck and stuff. And of course you drink drinks during the day, and you know, I had a monster energy drink this morning, and the reeds were stuck together, bad stuck together. And I was trying to get my tongue in between there, couldn't get them separated. So I just kind of made do with what I had. Eventually they started to break there towards the end, right before I killed him. But he had a hen directly across the slough from him, and she got real chatty with me. So I said, all right, you want to play this game, we can play that game, because they're either going to hit my side or they hit the other side. They hit the other side, I was pretty much out of the game. Started talking back and just kind of Tommy-topping her, and sure enough, he hit the ground at like 35 probably. And I was kind of scared it wasn't him at first. And then he got walked behind a big tree, and I kind of dropped my red dot to where I could see the top of it, and he just, yeah, that's him. And dropped strut, went to half strut, took about 5 steps, boom, laid him out. Just can't ride it up much better than that. And a fine turkey at that. Probably 1 1/4. 1 3/8. What a fantastic day. You know, every year, the season's coming closer and closer. I'm just wondering myself, do I still have it? You know, am I making the right decision to go where I'm going? Am I hunting a turkey that's ready to die? Is my calling up to par? Which is really, in my opinion, one of the most overrated things in the turkey, in your arsenal for turkey hunting. I think setup is 95% of it, and a good setup with bad calling trumps by far a bad setup with good calling. But every time you kill one, I just think, did I really just pull that off? Never gets old, man. Never gets old.